party. It was a clubhouse party, and we were all there having a good old time, and threw some slurs and whatnot, introduced ourselves to each other, and I guess that was it right there, you know what I'm saying?
So for those who aren't familiar with the clubhouse, please introduce the world to what the clubhouse is, because I mean, I know, and I could go on for days about the clubhouse. I have as many stories as probably you have, but, you know, let the people know what the clubhouse is, because I feel like as the clubhouse becomes more and more popular and produces more and more music, I feel like it starts to become more of an entity and not just like there are people behind this thing. There's you know, some people breathing life into this collective known as the clubhouse.
Yes, and the clubhouse breathing life into the music scene right now.
And that as well.
The clubhouse is this Victorian style mansion in Brooklyn, and it's got like 10 musicians living there.
A bunch of people who live in a house, but they also work with other people. So there are people that work on music at the clubhouse who don't live there, and then there are people who live in the clubhouse that don't work on music.
Yeah.
Does that make sense? So it's kind of like this thing that people, it's hard to kind of nail down. It's just like, it's a collective.
Does Brooklyn inspire you?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Every time I walk out of the door, it's like new things, new energy, all different kinds of people interacting with people that I probably wouldn't walk by and brush by in the street in Houston, Texas.
Yeah. I mean, as far as like New York goes, you guys hold New York down at pretty much all the major shows, you know, Hip Hop Fest, CMJ, I mean, like, We see you. It's not like you're just this dude making some music, you know, on a real, real humble level. Like you're really doing this and you're reaching people. You're out there.
Yeah, luck. You know, just work. I guess, you know, even a broken watch is right 2 times a day, right?
There you go.
And so I mean, like I said, it's just, if you're in it for the, I'm going to make this mixtape and try to become a new hot guy on the block, then I mean, it'd be something else. But I guess a few years pushing it, it just all comes together. As long as you're working with talented individuals and you work on your craft and you just hone it,
Then
things just keep coming. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I wanna play this little.
Yeah, we just dropped one at, you go to denitia, sene. .com, and that'll take you to the Bandcamp where we got Casanova, we have the blah 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 EP. There's 4 songs right now as far as this combo for this project or the string of releases right now. So that's the spot. DenitiaAndScene.com.
So you're not like, you're not a group. You're just people who respect each other's music and you just came together to do this record.
We're also a group.
We just launched the group, kid. We did that. We spoke about names and stuff. The records came first, you know what I'm saying? And so we were like, let's go with something real creative.
Yeah.
And we're like, all right, Denitia and
Scene.
Yeah.
It's
the N, but not the symbol. Oh, we switched it up on them.
Yeah,
kind of thing. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They actually have.
Okay. All right. So we're gonna shift gears a little bit. Yeah. Casanova record. Tell people about this new record you guys have.
Denitia and I singing a song called Casanova.
Anything else? No, just drop it. Is this a premiere? Can we jump out the window and say it's a premiere real quick?
I mean, radio premiere right here.
Make the world feel happy.
Mass Appeal radio premiere Casanova.
Before you hear it tomorrow or whenever you hear it here first.
It's true.
That's real massive. Let's go. Casanova. Boom.